Hey everyone, I'm JD. Welcome back to my channel. I've got something a little bit different to share this time. I've got a whole bunch of tag embellishments that I've made, and I'm going to try my very first tutorial. So we'll see how we go with that. I was inspired by Liz at the Paper Project, and I'm going to link her below, where she made these amazing cancelled stamp tag embellishments. And as soon as I saw her video, I went out and made my own. So I got this stamp from a Happy Mail package. I also got this garment pin from a Happy Mail package. So I thought, awesome, I've got the supplies. I can go make one. And that's what I made, with these three ribbons at the back and a bit of bling down the bottom. And I loved how it turned out. So what I did was, through one of the Facebook groups, I think it's a de-stash group. One of the ladies there was selling stamps, and so I bought a bulk lot, and I bought 80, and she actually chucked in through a few extras, and I got well over 100 there. I didn't end up counting them all because there were so many. And yeah, then I got online from Carefully Crafted, this one here, at Etsy. I bought these tags here. So I could have made my own, but I just went the lazy option and bought 50 of these. So got a lot of those. And then, actually, I made this one as well to show you. This was the first one I made with the stamps that I got in bulk. Just in one of my journals here. So I think it turned out nicely here with the lace at the back and a coloured button. Oh, and I also bought a whole bunch of garment pins. Those ones I got from A Tattered Dream. So I think I bought 50 of those as well. So, I'll just see if I can focus. Focus, focus, focus. Okay, there we go. Alright, so I'll first show you the tags that I've made, just to give you an idea. So I like to put at least three, oh sorry, at least two bits of ribbon at the back. Sometimes I put three. And yeah, I had fun choosing different coloured buttons. So some of them, I match them to the stamp. So this one's purple with a purple ribbon, and this one also has sparkles on the back. Oh, it's not focusing. But yeah, there you go. And then, yeah, a blue one. So I try to coordinate them with the stamp colours. This one's got a bit of yellow there, so red button and yellow ribbons. And then, yeah, some of them are more vintagey. And I just made a whole bunch. So in this bulk lot, I just spent one night doing this, and I made, I think it was 32 that I made in the end, or was it 34? 32 or 34. So yeah, I do things in bulk. I like to have them all ready to go. And then I can just choose the ones that I want, and I can put them in my journals. Bit tricky getting them to line up properly. There we go. This one's got a cool looking bell. I love this lace here that I got from A Tattered Dream. And so yes, some of these stamps I did get from the Happy Mail package as well. I got about 10 stamps. I think it was from a lady from Germany, so that was pretty cool. And yeah, blue one here. Green and red. I love the flower stamps. So I think when I get stamps again, what I'm going to do, oh, and I love the like the queen and the profile images as well. I think I'll ask for more floral stamps next time. Yeah, so that was one thing to learn, a good thing to learn. when getting stamps. So yeah, I love the flowers. Because yeah, not all stamps you want the image that it has. And I try to match the stamp to the journal. So if it's a vintage journal, try to get one that looks more vintagey. If it's a blue journal, I'll try and find a blue stamp. That kind of thing. Yeah, so whole bunch of tags. And I thought I'd show how I made them. So I start off, yeah, with these plain white tags, and then I got my coffee dyed solution, just water and coffee, in this spray bottle. And it's the first time I actually tried this spray technique. Usually I soak them in a tray, but this worked really well just for this spraying of tags. And so some I did lighter than others, and I did front and back, and just experimented with, yeah, how dark I wanted it. This one was actually a mistake. So I tried all different types of things that you can put on a stamp, on a tag. So as you can see, this one, I just put a bit of fabric on it. This one has some lace that had a black flower running through it. This one was this sheer fabric type stuff with glitter swirls on it. And this, oh, I can't remember which one it was, but there's a few actually where what I did, I peeled this off because I don't like how this looks. I'm sure I could figure out a way to make it work, but I was just like, that looks ugly. So I ripped it off, and it left like a really cool, because the coffee dye still was through it, so it left this cool pattern. And I'm just trying to find one. Okay, here. I'm not sure you'll be able to see, but it left this coffee dye pattern in the background. And so all I did was put some of this lace over the top, which was this one. And I just put it over the top, and it kind of, I like that effect. It still worked. So I love how you don't chuck out the mistake, you find a way to make it work. And yeah, I really like how that turned out. Yeah, so that's what I do. I grab my tag, coffee dyed tag, and then I choose some sort of fabric to put on top of it. So this one, again, is a different fabric. I coffee dyed it, like I sprayed it with the solution with the fabrics on. But like I said, with this one, I put the fabric on top of the coffee dye. So it could work either way, just depends what you want. I'll try and find another example. Like this one, I put a different ribbon lace trim at the back. And this one over here, I used, like it's a, I'll show you, these papers. So I just got this little notebook with these papers, and I covered it here, and then sprayed it with coffee dye just to give it that old vintage look. And yeah, then I put a bit of lace trim over the top, like a little collage. Trying to get into my collages, same here with like the ribbon here and then a bit of lace there, just to add that interest. Yeah, so what I do then, this one's already pre-prepared earlier, copy dyed on the back already. Let's see if that will focus for me. Coffee dyed. And I just put like a, I'll show you this one. This was the trim, the ribbon. And I just stuck that on top so it kind of mutes it. And then you grab your stamp, or you can do your coffee dyeing. You can add your laces after the top, like on top of that as well. Sorry, just grabbing my glue. Yeah, and you can just add whatever you want on there, layer it up or whatever, or keep it simple. And then I've just got my glue, so I use craft glue. Sorry, I'm not very good at this. It's my very first tutorial. Just trying to work out how to do this with the camera and everything. And look, see, there's this strand. Good to see that. And then you put this stamp on here. So I try and pick a stamp that matches the colours, so it's kind of got this gold here, so I've kind of chose a goldy coloured stamp, get all this glue off my fingers. Look at this. I really like the clear gum glue because it sticks nice and strong. And then you grab your button and your garment pin. And then put that through there so that the button is on the front. And then you can put your little trims. So I've already pre-cut these as well. And you stick those on the garment pins. Oh, I hope I'm in frame. I'm so sorry. I will hopefully get better at tutorials. And then you put your other ribbon at the back, and you can have as many ribbons as you want, really. And then just close it up. And there is your tag to add to a journal. So, yeah, have fun with your laces and ribbons and trims, and add whatever you would like. Like, you could also add little bits of ephemera or die cuts and things. You can add sequins and diamantes or whatever. So, yeah, I had fun with this one. I put like a blue ribbon down the bottom, so it's a kind of wavy ribbon, and it's a boat or something, so I kind of, it's a boat in the waves. Anyway, and then blue to kind of keep that theme of blue water, ocean, waves. Yes, so I had a lot of fun with this, and I was thinking, because I make so many, and I don't know, I just love giveaways, and gifts is my love language. If you've heard of love languages, you'll know what I'm talking about. I just love to give things away, and because I make so many, I would love to give one away, or two or three away. So if you're watching this and you're like, wow, they look really cool and I would love to use one in my journals, let me know. And like, I did a really quick look at them all. Tell me which one maybe was your favourite, or which colours you like or something. And yeah, I will, I don't know, choose out of a hat and maybe one or two or three, I don't know, people, I'm not sure how, I should have thought about this before, will win their favourite tag stamp, I don't know. But no, it's not a competition or anything, it's just, I shouldn't have said win. Just say which one you like, and yeah, I will. I can't give everyone one, that's why I'm saying, like, I'll have to put it all in a hat or something. But yeah, I would love to share some of these with you all. Same with my envelopes. So this video is getting way too long. I'll do that in another video. But anytime I make something in bulk, I would like to give some of them away as well. So yeah, that's what I hope to do in the future. And yeah, just let me know your favourite, and if you like these tags, and check out Liz at The Paper Project as well. And yeah, thank you so much for watching.